And we're back, guys, and we are done. Tablehood just over here has officially ended. And look at everything's all packed up and cleaned up. They actually ended up on their variable die ending and ended up ending the game. Over here in Table of Bismarck, we had a pre-planned time to end our game. It was not the variable ending that we wanted, because of course everything gets so darn scripted then, because then people can actually start figuring out where they want to go. The Italians came down here, took Aiden from us, sneaky Italians for the British, or from the British, stealing a victory point. The Germans did invade actually once again, but up here in Scotland and the British Midlands, and took a victory point away from us too. But there was not much else we could do. The Americans here, it was actually my idea, to have the Russians, or the British, lend lease everywhere so we could have an airborne and a strap bomber here to stop and get our victory point back from the Italians that came down here with the 2nd Navy to actually seize, I think it was Dutch Surinam or whatever from the Dutch, because it was unoccupied. So that was one thing. Right here, when we took, defended London, the Germans came in, wiped our Marines out of the British Midlands. But this is what the British defended at. We only had 3 fighters, 2 tacticals, and a whole lot of men, but we slaughtered the Luftwaffe. We took out 5 medium bombers, 3 fighters, a tactical bomber, and 2 strategic bombers. The anti-aircraft gun actually even got 2 hits. So, of course, a little too late, but nonetheless, it was a bit of pride. That was for sure. Bit of pride also. The British landed in West Poland. I had the Russians lend-lease me a strat bomber, and we had an airborne up there. And guess what? We took West Poland, a victory point away from them, to knock them down a peg. We were trying to play spoiler, too. We knew we probably weren't going to quite win the game. We were close, because had we done that, this team over here would have ended up winning. But instead, what we have here is we have a Axis victory on Table Bismarck. So that's Global War 36 Enthusiast. And also, Madman Dan, who's playing Japan, did a fabulous game. Fabulous game. Did very well. And they not only won the table, they won the tournament, because they had the most victory points out of all of us. And I believe here from this chicken scratchings, we can deduce they actually, I think, had 16 victory points. Over here, the Axis on this table, who also won this table on Tablehood, they got, I believe, I think they got 14 victory points. Then 3rd place would go to the next best team with victory points. And big hats off to Jinx, my teammate. He really made it happen. We scrammed through and actually I think we got 10 victory points in total. Maybe 9, but I think it was a total of 10. And then, of course, we were fortunate because had the game kept on going, we might have lost more victory points, but we had to end it on a certain time. But this table over here, General Hand Grenade and Rank Carcass, they did well, but I believe they only got 7 victory points, giving them 4th place. And then the Russians, had they won a turn before or quit a turn before, they actually might have won the game, played by Friendly Fire. He actually got knocked down to 3 victory points, and he was winning up to that point. But of course, he invaded Iraq and gave the chance for the Allies to take some territory back, and gobbled up many areas, especially Iran and Mongolia and so on and so forth. But anyways, the Russians here unfortunately didn't get it, score a single victory point because of the total destruction here in the West, and the CCP were just unfortunately a little bit too weak to gather their victory point against the KMT. So Kaiser Siriana, he did not get much for victory points, but he did influence his peers, and he got right here the most diplomatic commander and the most honorable commander. So he got the Order of the October Revolution and the Order of Lenin given to him. And Madman Dan, I believe, got the Iron Cross Award for being the most strategic. So that is awesome for him, which is not, of course, right here. He got a few prize picks. He picked this very nice one thing from Historical Board Gaming. So I know he's going to love that. And, of course, everybody got their pins and medals awards. We had 2 general promotions, too, as well. Those general promotions are... we had 4. So Madman Dan, winning this table, got promoted from 1 general to two-star admiral now. So he's an actual admiral over here, and you can see this with a little bit more visual. And of course, Hilltop Pillbox, who was playing the Japanese on Table Hood, also won his game, so he gets a promotion to a two-star admiral as well. And the two generals, the two teammates they had, was Global War Enthusiast and Moose from Edmonton. And that is actually Rank Carcass's brother. So that was nice of him to receive that that award. Of course, there's not much to show you over here, but it was actually a very, very good game. But there's too quick for me, and they packed up right away. And then, of course, over here, we have the Great Cup. We have third place right here, which we've already put on. And we have the Clash of the Titans, Jinx and Sky Marshal, who came through with that. We have our first place champions right here, Global War 36 Enthusiast and Madman Dan. And then, of course, over here, we have the Axis on Table Hood coming in second place. And you can see the themes of the year and, of course, the people who won. So very, very awesome. The rest of the plates that were not used are given away as souvenirs. But nonetheless, we have completed our second year for this tournament. So that is very, very nice. And we'll have to change a few things there. So we had two Axis and an Allies this year placed on the cup. So that's really awesome. Most of the prizes have all been gone. There's a few remnants here and here, but everybody, we gave away everything. Big, big thanks from Doug from Historical Board Gaming. Actually, right here is the Iron Cross awarded to Madman Dan, the most strategic commander. So now this will go with his Legion of Merit for the Allies as well. And we'll just briefly go over here and just show you that. And this is where these medals come into play. So big, big hats off to Kaiser Siriana. He was the first one in the Summer Offensive history to win two medals from these peer-voted medals. And he did win quite decisively. A lot of people admired him, or he was very diplomatic. And of course, we gave away that beautiful Order of Lenin, the Iron Cross, and the Order of the October Revolution. So super excited about that. It's my honor to give that to them. And just a lot of fun. Just a lot of fun overall, guys. So anyways, all in all, though, we did get some victory points over here. The Americans, of course, built a few more battleships to replenish their stock, and of course we have the British fleet that actually joined up in this area here. We didn't really do too much battling, but yeah, they were up actually up here. And the British fleet made it all the way to Japanese home waters with the Ark Royal, Rodney. You can see all the great forces there, as well as the American First Fleet. So definitely putting the hurt on Japan had we gone a little bit further. And incidentally, Japan did not get any victory points. Sad and true. They were hamstrung quite tough. And as much as the Netherlands did fall to the Germans, Japan did not have a chance to take the Dutch territories away. The Italians did their bit of sneaky moves, and obviously they hid the Littorio, their battleship here, because unfortunately we had our battleships and capital ships out of range to really influence that, which would have been nice had we done that, but just to steal a victory point away from them, or possibly even give us one. Losing Aden was a bit of a choker, but not much once again we could have done with that. And even after all those losses, the Germans still had quite an air force. I think they have close to 7, 8, 9 jet fighters. So, and then of course, many other fighters. So the heir of the new Third Reich is upon us. They did go into Denmark, and then of course the Danish ship right there fled, and the Haida, the Canadian destroyer, came up just for some prestige, sunk 4 German transports since we knew this was the end of the turn, and that's why they were sacrificed. Of course, the Swedes, being as neutral as they are, got to get up to their full strength, and that poor airborne in West Poland may not live long, but you know what? He did his job to knock the Axis down a little bit. So very happy with that. You can see the strength here with Russia. Russia still would have held on, but I don't think it was a big fake focus for the Allies, or the Axis, I should say. So anyways, guys, This is Sky Marshall here bringing a close, or at least a partial close, to the 2022 summer offensive. And we will all see you guys in the future, or maybe we might do one or two more video recaps. But this is it, guys. Congratulations once again to Global War 36 Enthusiast and Madman Dad for winning the tournament. And everybody else who participated, I am extremely happy you guys came. Thanks, and we'll talk to you soon.